Sit those masters. Good evening, everyone.
Hi.
What does Canada Day remind to you?
Fireworks
is the topic for the speech tonight. Like many other Canadians and most of the people in downtown, last week, Hannah and I, we went to Cole Harbour to watch the fireworks. It was a beautiful night. I don't know if any of you were there, but it was a really nice night. A nice cold breeze, but not super cold. And it was clear skies, everything was perfect. So we go there at like 9:30, and a really nice energy too. Tons of people, probably a few thousand. They're all waiting for the fireworks. At 10 o'clock, fireworks started as expected, and it was a great show. It went on for about like 15 to 20 minutes. And as soon as the show was done, this is what we were left with.
Yeah. Right.
A lot of smoke.
Yeah.
It was nice during the fireworks, but as soon as the fireworks was done, in 15 minutes, whole Cole Harbour was covered with smoke. And I'm like, wow, that's a lot of smoke for 15 minutes of entertainment. So I go back home and I check what that all that smoke is about. And now, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests, I need your help. We need to stop this silly type of entertainment that we somehow adopted from where I don't know. It may be our neighbors, they do the same on the July the 4th, but we need to find a reason and do something about it. The reason why, let me start with why I call it silly. First of all, what is the relation between fireworks and Canada Day?
Celebration.
Why fireworks is related to celebration?
Tradition.
So do you think that on Canada Day, when they did the Constitution Act in 1867, they had fireworks?
Yeah!
Probably not. They had some firearms, but they didn't have fireworks at the time.
Yeah.
And the second thing is,
it's...
They did what?
Fire the cannons.
Yeah, there you go. The second thing is, it's always the same stuff. Year after year after year, it's always the same fireworks. Yes, they do add a couple new colors here and there, and maybe like in different shapes. They have like circles and squares and all that, but it's basically the same stuff. So why do we keep repeating it? What is all entertaining about it? If they took us all to Cole Harbour and showed us the same movie every year, would we go watch it?
Yeah.
Probably not. maybe James would, but not a lot of people.
Good.
So I really looked into it. I wanted to find out why it started and why we are doing it. And if we can do something better than fireworks. I looked into it and there is no apparent reason. No one ever did anything, as actually Harvey mentioned. It's just a tradition that it started at some point. They didn't have anything else to do. They did it, people liked it, and they have been doing it since then. But I think we can do something much better than that. Because what I realized is in that 15 minutes, they had the fireworks, but there is nothing related to Canada Day. In 15 minutes, people watch, kids watch the fireworks, but in 15 minutes, nobody even talked about Canada. Nobody even appreciated why we are in Canada, everything is so good, whatever. So I think if we came all together, we can do something much better than this. Why? Because it pollutes our environment. That smoke that you see, contains a lot of unburned hydrocarbons, which are really bad for us. It contains a lot of heavy metals, like mercury and other things that are not really good for us. And also, the lights that eventually drop to the water, that left over, pollutes the water too. And if you're not that much worried about the pollution, all this also costs our city, for 15 minutes of entertainment, $100,000. Now, I don't know about you, but if someone gave me $100,000, and asked me to do something entertaining, I don't think I would buy fireworks. Would you?
No.
No. So why does the city of Vancouver does it? Because it's easy. They have been doing it, someone just needs to do something for the Canada Day, and they keep doing it. But I think if we did something better, and if we came up with a better plan, we could change this. On Canada Day, we could actually have some entertaining activities. And I have some ideas for it. Remember that stage that had with the Olympic rings.
Yeah.
We could take the Olympic rings off and bring the stage back into the Broad Inlet where they have the fireworks and have start the night with an inspirational speech. Someone could talk about Canada, why Canada Day was Canada Day and how it started, why Canada is a great place to live. Then we could have some kind of a concert or something, maybe or in a symphony, maybe some other person. Then we could bring some influential people, like the Olympic athletes. They could talk about Canada and tell, give the kids a good message instead of just shooting fire in the air. I think we can make this happen, but the only way to make this happen is to be proactive and do something about it. And I think this is a great venue, so I need your help. I think if we did this and if we got enough traction from EETC, we could have this as a social program. We could also use it as a venue for speaking, practicing our public speaking, because we will have to go to other clubs, talk about it, and try to persuade them. And if we did this next year, in 2011, Canada Day could be a day where people actually do think about Canada. And they can actually do something about it. They would appreciate the place that they live and know the reasons why they should be doing it. Canada Day could be a day that on July the 2nd, people don't forget right away that it was Canada Day yesterday. If we did this all together, I think we can make it happen, but this city needs your help to make it happen. So who would like to involve? Perfect. Thank you, Mr. Toastmaster.